Hey guys, welcome back to MuscleMentor.net. I'm Brad Hall and this is Justin Harris, and we are answering some questions that we got off Facebook. And this one is how to know if you are overtraining and how much is too much. And Justin's pretty passionate about this one.
Well, so two things. One important thing, and I've probably had arguments with this with other coaches. If you have to worry about overtraining, don't expect to go very far in the sport. That's just the way it is. I've trained with top guys. I had a top pro current that was my training partner for a number of years, and they don't get overtrained. That's not a worry of theirs. And so if you have goals of going deep into the sport and becoming a professional bodybuilder, and overtraining is a major issue with you, a major concern, major worry, that you might want to reevaluate your goals, because it's just not something you didn't see Ronnie Coleman get overtrained. I mean, the guy trained 6 days a week, you know, for 25 years, and every workout was, you know, balls to the wall, heavy and hard. And that, so with that being said, most people aren't in that situation. Most people do have to worry about overtraining. And there's lots of indicators. I mean, if you're not progressing anymore, you need to kind of step back and think about how things are going. There's some common markers are fatigue, not able to sleep well, headaches, loss of appetite. If you have any of those things and you think you might be overtrained, it's likely that you are. If you're going to the gym and you're no longer progressing in strength, or worse, even decreasing in strength, if you have little nagging injuries that are building up, there's all signs. I mean, there's no one sign you walk into the gym and boom, suddenly you're overtrained. But there are markers, you know, like we said, headaches, you're getting more sore, not getting sore, or you're losing strength. You're not motivated to work out. You're tired all the time, or you're not sleeping at night. Things like that. Pay attention to them, you know. And if you don't want to go to the gym and you're really forcing yourself to go there, and that's a good sign that you're overtraining. Even if you're not, whether the word is overtrained or not, if you're not. You're not fired up to go to the gym, you need to reevaluate. If you don't have an appetite, you need to reevaluate. Yep. If you're not able to sleep, you need to reevaluate. Whether it's overtraining or not, you need to step back and kind of take a look at some things.
And sometimes people do it the wrong way. So, they lose their appetite and they try and address it by eating more, or mm-hmm. where they're not motivated to go to the gym, so they try and figure out a way to train force differently or force it. And really what your body's telling you is back off for a second. So sometimes, whether it's food or the gym or something like that, that one step back is going to allow you to take those two steps back forward. And I think that's what happens, is to get really deep in overtraining where it's actually a problem, like that true overtraining, is when people don't listen to the little signals that Justin was talking about.
But I think part of me, and this is another thing certain coaches I know would really like to get an argument with me about, but I just feel it's a little silly to me that you don't go to other sports and have people legitimately fearful that they're working too hard. Yeah. And to me, coming from, a wrestling, football, multi-sport background, go to a wrestling practice, the idea that, oh, coach, God, I could have won state champions, I just worked too hard. It's just, it's just not there in other sports, Like, no golfers, like, man, I should have been on the tour, but I just had this thing where I had to practice my golf swing all the time, and I played too much golf. And so, I mean, your body gets beat down and stuff, and bodybuilding is a sport where that's a legitimate concern. Another sport would be like long distance running, and people do overdo it with that. But in general, the average person worries far too much about overtraining. The idea that you're going to work too hard and not achieve your goals is really kind of silly if you look at it that way. And I say that, I have to give the caveat, because someone's going to email and say, oh, you say overtraining is not real. No, it is real. I'm just saying it's not something...
It's hard. It's hard to do.
It's not something you need to be fearful of every day. Because you got to work pretty darn hard to be chronically overtrained.
Yeah. The same with losing a ton of muscle by doing a little bit of cardio.
Yeah.
It's harder to lose muscle than you think.
Yeah.